What's happening? We in Cleveland right now. This Big Wish, Bone Thugs, you know, back on the scene, baby.
Man, it's going down, the movie, you know what I'm saying? It's about some young brothers with dreams, you know.
Like, what if
dreams didn't really come true? Like, what if really Bone Thugs and Harmony didn't get on that bus to California and make our dreams come true?
You know, what if we would have never got on that bus to go down there and meet Easy? What we would have been doing? It's gonna be a breeze, you know what I'm saying?
Ain't no nervousness to it, man. You know what I mean? We've been waiting all our lives to do this, you know what I'm saying? So we ready, baby. It's going down.
Please, we finally get to do something, branch out and do some of the things we've been wanting to do, but never had the budget, but it's on the cracking right now. In the scope, hey.
The original idea was to shoot 5 days in Cleveland, all our exteriors, plus the music video, and then come back to LA for 2 weeks and shoot out the rest of the film. That didn't necessarily go as planned because the biggest blizzard to hit Cleveland in 15 years struck right when we showed up.
Bone Thugs, A-Kind, yeah.
You know, no nothing come easy. You gotta try real, real hard. I tried hard, but I guess I gotta try harder.
I try so hard. Seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard. Will always be a victim of these streets.
You know, we out here in the corner of 79th Street in St. Clair, in the hood, in Cleveland. Yeah, the white boy is in Cleveland on St. Clair. We out here, I don't know, it's about 3 in the morning. We're about to shoot this shot with Akon and Bone Thugs. I try so hard.
I'll be posted up right here. Ain't sleep, hell, snow, but hell, snow. Until then.
Well, the inspiration came from the incarceration, you know. I got locked up, man. That kind of opened up a whole nother future for me. In a way, you can almost say it was a blessing because it was that experience that got me really focused on what to do in my future. You know, music definitely was a hobby at one point, but coming out as a convicted felon, you really can't get like a legitimate job that's going to keep you holding over every month with all these overwhelming responsibility. So the music was the only thing that can keep that same lifestyle and still be able to do what I love to do and make a lot of money doing it. So that pretty much how the decision came about.
I know Akon from like 2000 and shit, you know, I'm down in the ATL, so it's family, man. It's a pleasure to really make this thing go down. You know what I mean? His harmonies, he already into harmonies and singing, and you know what I mean? It blend crazy.
That's made heaven, kid. I'm sure y'all already know, man. I ain't gotta overemphasize how much talent these cats got, how much they brought to the game and distributed, how much they style influenced so many other people. Like, it's incredible. I'm just happy to be involved with it.
Bone Thugs and Harmony feature Akon, produced by Akon, baby. That's real big for us. We loving it.
Cheese, nigga, cheese.
What's the song mean, man?
Basically, we just talking about how, you know what I'm saying, we put so much work in, and sometimes we don't get the love back. So we just still trying, and our struggle never ends because we try so hard.
Already came in as trendsetters, you know, changing the game. So now we with the movie / video. The movie is actually called I Tried. We done went through a couple names, you know what I'm saying, and that really fit the script. The I Tried concept, the struggle of the game is really like, it's really there. It fell together, you know what I mean? About 10 degrees outside. We out here standing on the block like, you know, how it used to go down. That's what we did. Now we went from selling rocks to shooting movies, baby.
Please believe it.
That's a wrap!
Yo, this gotta be the most coldest video shoot I've ever experienced in my life. I don't know who the hell idea this was.
All right, so that's a wrap on day one. We just finished up with Akon. We got 4 more days here in Cleveland, 2 more weeks in LA. Day 2 is up tomorrow.
It's a wrap for me. I'm done with my parts. So y'all lucky, y'all home watching in the warmth. But right now, if y'all knew what it was like to be out in this cold doing what we do, I think you'd change your mind about being a celebrity. Shit, ain't no joke. I'm out.
So the story for the movie, I Tried, kind of goes along with the song, the idea of struggle and never giving up, and it, when things go bad, you just got to try that much harder to make it happen. So in film, Lazy's girlfriend ends up dying at the end of Act One. So when we start in Act Two, it's 6 years later, and we find that Lazy's now a narcotics detective.
I become a detective because they take my girl, and you know, I go crazy. I got an alcohol problem. You know, I'm kind of really not there. I'm just, the hood hate me, you know what I'm saying? It's just crazy as a motherfucker, but you know, I'm gonna avenge my broad's death, so my girl's death.
Crazy is, then we find out he's dealing drugs, and he's still trying to make the music thing happen, but it's really not going as planned.
You know, I'm the one that never got a 9-to-5, that didn't make it off the block. You know what I'm saying? So I'm still like petty hustling drugs.
And for Wish, in the end of Act One, his girl gets pregnant, so he's got to do the right thing now.
My role is basically, you know what I'm saying, I'm still like in the streets, but you know what I'm saying, I'm like, I got a 9-to-5 job because my girl want me to do the right thing, but I'm still trying to do the music thing, but she sweating me so hard because I'm still doing little stuff on the side.
I mean, nah, I don't think I would have became no detective, you know what I'm saying, but you know what I mean, you know, but life take real serious turns on people, you know what I'm saying, so you never know where you can end up at in life, you know, that's why to me it's like, it's going to be fun playing the cop, you know what I mean, I always been on the other side of the other side of that picture, you know what I'm saying, but you know, life is a motherfucker, so.
Go loco with the heater, not me, la mira, now la mira, la mira, la mira.
Took it back to the old days for real. I mean, we was really all together. You know what I'm saying? Recording this album. We was in the studio, vibed up, man. And, you know, them ideas was ringing off the walls. And, you know what I'm saying? We really got into each other and collaborated this go around. You know what I'm saying? So, Bone Thugs, the strength and loyalty. Meaning, you know, we had to stand strong through everything we went through. You know, we stayed loyal to each other.
This album is a lot of collaborations. We got a lot of nice features. And the producers is really off the hook. It's just something we ain't never did before that we always wanted to do. We hoping everybody love it. We know they gonna love it because we put our work into it. We put our hearts into this one for real.
It ain't no comeback. It's just to let motherfuckers know Bone Thugs and Harmony ain't never went nowhere.
Bone Thugs got a story that's similar to Mike Jones. You can ask my homies. I remember back in the days when they didn't want me. Now I blew up, they all on me. They smiles phony. It's hard to determine who really is with you. These this fake. They trying to eat out of your plate and you can't get a break. Now how much can you take for heaven's sakes? I can't wait. They got me listening to the wind blow.
Yeah, yeah, this Bone Thugs, y'all behind the scenes again. What's this day three, but technically day two because it's been snowing like a mother.
It's been so crazy.
We've been snowed out for a couple of days, so we're doing it real early today. We're trying to catch up, and it's cold and a witch's titty out there.
Man, it's so cold out here, man. Motherfucking Eskimo. It's about 6 degrees with the wind chill factor. I think it's like 16 below. I heard on CNN this morning, you know, in Cleveland don't be on CNN. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, it was on CNN this morning just saying like, this is the coldest Cleveland has been in the past 20 to 30 years. And we picked this time of all time to do the video.
And we want it to be cold and snow a little, but we want it to be, you know, look like the North Pole down here.
And we need to go put these here on right here, no, player.
No, where the other pair at?
Huh? You got the other pair over there. And when they tell you Cleveland boys get they hustle and they grind on, man, that's what we do, man. Out here in this snow, it ain't no joke. But you know, we never give up. We never say die. You know, we keep it moving, man. So we gon' make it happen.
I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard, always be a victim of these streets. It ain't my fault, cause I try to get away, but trouble follows me. And still I try so hard, hoping one day you'll come and rescue me. But until then, I'll be posted up right here.
Hey, it's all good. I got my long johns on now, man. I've been asking for them for 2 days, but we finally got those things. The snow done slowed everything down. You know, but it's all good. We make it happen, baby. We trying right now. Now, when it's done, we all gonna sit back over a cup of cocoa or something, unthaw.
Welcome to Witches Hidden.
That is a wrap on the day. We're going big tomorrow, though. Stay tuned.
Day 2 of 30.
Day 30 of 20. Rolling and
action. Just got finished doing a running scene. The police is chasing me. We're on a set of music video, Akon, Bone Thugs and Harmonies. I Try, we're in the middle of Cleveland. And it's a beautiful day to be filming, opposed to the weather. Prohibited us from filming a couple other days. Take three.
I'm Chris Malky, I'm playing Officer Spring. Oh, hi. Yeah, I got snow in my boots from chasing the perp through the snow, so I'm drying out my boots.
What's happening here is we got a little chase sequence we've been filming kind of all day. And this is the end of the chase sequence where our officer arrests the would-be villain. And now we're gonna get ready to go to the very end of the sequence where we actually reveal he's really just an up-and-coming student. He's doing the right thing. This is all a case of mistaken identity because he's trying to do the right thing, and that's the essence of the song.
Standing around freezing.
Standing around freezing. 101 production. Hurry up and wait.
It's sunny. It looks sunny, and it is sunny. But we're a long way from the sun.
Meaty. Little T. Man. I'm only 14. I'm getting dough.
I'm 13. Not making paper.
We're gonna be on TV, man. Just y'all gonna get to hear my demo.
We right here in the hood where Bone Thugs grew up, right off of St. Clair, East 99th Street.
You don't want to fall in front of him because we're shooting right there, okay?
Oh, okay.
All right, go ahead.
Action two!
We're doing this little scene right now. They're robbing the store. You know, we got our DJ Ice, who's been our DJ for a long, long time and a childhood friend of the guys. He's playing a little acting role in this. Police pull up.
I didn't do it, man. I'm telling you, it wasn't me.
We're about to do some performance later on the corner, East 99 St. Clair with Bone.
Cut.
As you can see right now, I'm pretty much had enough. My hands are shaking. It's cold as hell out here. Cleveland's a real city. Word up. I just can't take it no more. I'm sorry. I gotta go get warm. My hands are shaking uncontrollably. And I'm just, it's getting colder by the second. All right.
These are some warm socks. Look at these. Ah, nice. Evil socks. Warm socks.
See, down's how we ride. Shot down's how we ride. Midwest how we ride. Come see how we feel. See down's how we ride.
Oh man, you gotta bring it home, man. You know what I'm saying? It feel good to be representing Cleveland. To get a city hope that it's things, you know, you can do it out here in this world, you know what I mean? It's just a positive vibe all through the land, you know what I mean? So you gotta bring it home, man, you know, because this is where we was brought up at, you know what I mean? These are the communities we wanna bring up with us, you know what I'm saying? So what we doing?
You see, we in the land right here on the street we grew up at in our hood. You know, taking it back, you know, giving something back to the hood, letting them know it is a way out. You know, you can do it. Just try hard.
Try hard, baby. We was raised out here doing what we had to do to survive and, you know, get by and do our thing. But East 99, that's the core of the Bone Thugs' existence. The Bone Yard right over there, you know what I mean, where we had the burning barrels going. This where Cray used to live over here to the left, 724. You know what I'm saying? So, it's right. We at home, dog.
What did it do?
Very diverse. Growing up. It's all the madness, because every day's a challenge. And man, I'm slipping. Can't lose my balance. I'm trying not to panic.
Cut! Cut!
When it hit number one, everybody give everybody a call and say congratulations because we made this shit happen. You know what I mean? Rain, sleet, hail, snow.
It went down, Bone Thugs, we getting it in. We trying to make the best out of a bad situation from St. Clair, showing the young youth that it's positive things going on out here. And Bone Thugs gonna set the example. You know, we got Bone, LeBron, Cleveland off the hook, man. I ain't gonna tell you.
Yo, I think it's really time we let these niggas know what's going on with Bone Thugs, man. Yeah, they don't know, they don't know, they don't know. The movie was supposed to take place in Cleveland, you know what I'm saying? But as you know, we got snowed out, we got stuck in the blizzard out there, we had to shut everything down. And it was going to be about, you know, what if we never even got on the bus to come to California? You know, but we had to change the whole script around once we had to come to LA and shoot the film, you know, so we just made it to where, like, we actually did get on the bus, but when we got here, you know what I'm saying, we never made it back to meet Easy, you know what I'm saying, and we ended up getting stuck out here, like, just, like, hustling and just falling into the California life.
You don't want no problem with them Bone Thug boys. You don't want none. You don't want none.
C98, take 3.
Action! Oh, shit. What we got here? Look like somebody done tripped over their feet.
Cut!
Man, it's cool, you know what I'm saying? I really felt like I had to get into that. I had to build up to that scene, you know? A lot of things was going on that I had to handle, and I'm really getting my focus on to really get my act on and really concentrate on these lines. But all in all, when I jumped into that shit, it went down very, very good. You know, I'm feeling good, man. I'm getting into this acting thing. I like it. I'm about to take me a motherfucker down right now.
Okay, Lazy.
It's your boy Nipsey Hussle. I play Lil Ricky in the movie. Just an average dude on the block doing what he do, grinding and all that, so. That got me in my natural element, a little fly, it came out cool. My acting debut was a major success, you know what I'm saying? Flossing boy, Nip Hussle.
Here we go, fine everyone. And action.
I'm the victim here.
How you doing? I'm Hassan Johnson. I play KP and I tried alongside with Wish, Lazy, and Crazy Bone. It's always fun playing the bad guy. It's not bad playing the good guy. That has its perks too, but the bad guy's always, you know, got a gloat in the, you know, the light and until his time is up.
Fight everyone!
You know, this is like that climax. You all start to figure everything out along with the characters. That's what's cool about it too. Bang! So that's what we're trying to put together is a work of art, a masterpiece. I mean, you better scream and scream loud.
Yeah, we on break right now, so this probably won't make the cut or whatever the hell y'all shooting for right now, but it's a little recreation we partaketh in, you know. A little Xbox, a little cigarette, you know.
Whip your gun around.
Don't even try it.
It's a good movie, you know, it's way different than what's going on right now. I think the only thing closest to our shit that got a message I heard lately was a Ludacris record. So it's one of them, you know what I mean? It ain't no shake your ass or you ain't gonna see no fly bitches or nothing that's gonna stimulate your mind. As if you got a mind.
I heard the angel in charge of the water say.
My name is Anna Maria Horsford, and I am Emily's mother, the girlfriend of Crazy, who I'm trying to keep on the straight and narrow and trying to help him and influence him as much as I can. And he's a nice fella, gives me a little money to help out. He's a nice fella.
All right, let's run it again.
Oh yeah, man, this acting is way different than shooting music videos, I tell you that much, for real. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a lot more into it, not more camera shots, you know what I'm saying? You got to be on time. Everything is constantly moving on the movie set, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's different, man, but it's fun. It's something I can get used to. Something I am going to get used to, because this is my next move, trust me.
Lazy, Crazy, and Wish. So we got them acting coaches before we started the film. Every single one of the acting coaches came back and basically said these guys are naturals. They they don't need any teaching necessarily, as they need to just kind of hone the skills. They already have the skills there. The intensity's there. They're reacting, not just acting. They're reacting and doing all the things that a real actor would do, and they're doing a really great job.
Getting my young Denzel on out here, man, it really, really feel good. It's really the first time I've really been a part of something like this, you know what I mean? So I'm crafting the art. I really got the urge to be a student for this shit right now and really, like, try to pull it out and, you know, do some movies, man.
Oh man, it's cool. It seems like it's really coming kind of natural, though. You know what I mean? It's like every day is a little bit of an acting. Everyday life.
It's not gonna work. Well,
kind of come kind of natural to me.
In Hollywood, here I come, man. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of soldiers in the PNA ain't never coming home. Can you find it in your heart to pray? So it seems everything going wrong, and you're just trying to find your way. Mama just wanna feed her babies, trying to keep a safe place to stay.
I'm in the hood right now, where a lot of people can't come. I guess you have to have a pass to come in here and do films. And we got the pass from my homies. So we out here, 60th and Hyde Park.
Right now you in the hood. We on 60th, as you've seen. That's what we named after. That's the neck of the woods you in right out here in LA. People come down here, you know, they want to come into your neighborhood, because they want to get a real ghetto or that inner city vibe. They just want to come show up, bounce up by his house, by where we grew up, and sweat blood, sweat and tears all over this. And then they just think they're going to come with some cameras and say, oh, well, we're going to film right here and throw some little actors on. We like, nah, we don't do that.
You know, Steve is family, Bone Thugs is family, you know what I'm saying? Really nobody was allowed to shoot over here in the 60s. But you know, hey, family is family, you know?
That is about community getting jobs around here, helping out, looking out. It's all family, so it's all good. That's where we at with it, and it's all hood.
Neighborhood.
You know what you're getting here? This is exclusive. Des Love is a crackhead, okay, on the Bone Thugs right now. My star, I'm a co-star. Everybody know who that is. You don't need no introduction. I'm a motherfucking crackhead. And I'm snitching, y'all. It's the only time you're gonna ever hear me say that. Cause this ain't me. You know what I mean? This ain't the DLOV. Transforming. Mutate.
Y'all know what this is. Oh, this scene is beautiful, man. This scene here is actually when I find Mookie dead. You know what I mean? And it's a detective crime scene, and I come over and it's a lot of smart aleck ass cops. That's really giving me a hard time.
Right, he's a friend of yours, huh?
Picked him up for possession once or twice.
Shauna Sawson. Los Angeles-based actress. Me and Chris Mulkey play sort of two of the same type of cops that hate the little guy. He falls outside the line, and we like lines.
My name is Mookie. I'm supposed to get killed in this scene. I ain't gonna die. You heard?
I'm feeling the character, Detective House, you know what I'm saying? And I was kind of, you know, like reluctant at first, you know, me playing the cop. Come on, man. But, you know, it's acting, so we having a good time with the shit.
I'm going to tell y'all something. That being covered in blood ain't fun. I got blood all down my back, all down my butt cheeks, everywhere. I got to go take a shower. I'm still trying to get the blood off me, you know what I mean? But I still look good, though, doing it, you know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about? You know.
I'm gone. I'm wrapped for the day. I'm early, you know what I mean? Time to roll up soon that la-la.
Yeah.
Oh,
man, what's happening, little man? To yours?
We're shooting Wish picking up roadkill for the first time and seeing these little kids, and we find out what Wish does for the first time in act two of the film.
And this is a real job, we found out. It's a person that scoops up roadkill for the city, but on occasion will work for the coroner's office and collect dead bodies at crime scenes.
One man's misery is another man's salvation. Remember that.
I'm Raymond Cham, and in this movie, I starred as a kid that saw a dog on the street dead There was a, what's his name? His name, Wishbone, came and scooped up the dog and made sure no one saw what happened, and that's what I did.
How old are
you? And I'm 10 years old. I dance, hip-hop, breaking, tap, and my mom wants me to do jazz.
You don't dance. I don't believe that. Let me see you dance.
Okay.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound it saved a wretch like me.
Oh man, that singer is awesome, my nigga, you know what I mean? Very, very beautiful, might I add. She doing her thing, man, y'all know that's Felicia. You know what I mean? My wife also doing her thing out here in the movie. Lady pretty in red up there, man. That's all I can say.
You and me throw money, don't stop it. You don't deal, don't deal. Don't my eyes at up. You don't deal on me. They know that I did. Boy.
Yeah, man, we got all the kids here, you know what I'm saying, trying to give them some little parts in the movie. They've been, my kids been begging me, please, let us be in the movie. So it's like, you got to put them in, you know what I'm saying? So they all here kicking it with each other. It's been a minute since they all seen each other, you know what I'm saying? So they having a good old time right now.
Yeah, later on tonight, I think we got a candlelight visual for the girl that actually gets killed in the film. We're gonna actually have all our kids doing the like the memorial thing for that. So, you know, so we can get our little kids and they're getting them a little shine too, nigga, you know.
You know we get it on the night, so we gotta keep it cracking. Say, what's poppin'?
What's poppin'?
Stay back.
It's my girl's house, man. What happened?
Time to check the singles ads.
Excuse me?
Just stay behind the table.
Man, fuck that, man. Yeah, this is the scene where we find out that Gia and her father got murdered. So this is Gia's and her father's house. And this is the crime scene that I'm walking up on. And, you know, I'm kind of flipping because I find out my girl got killed.
But the cop is doing a good job.
The cop.
After all that running in the snow in Cleveland, how crazy is that?
Oh, man, it's too cold, too cold.
It's too cold.
Big Mac, Willie McGinnis, just hanging out, man, behind the scenes. I guess we're at the finale, the shootout, so it's really going down. Somebody's about to die, or a few people about to die. I think they sold me out, man. They had me playing a detective. You know, I'm from the hood, so what better way to make my debut is that, you know, as a detective. But it was cool, man. I got to wear a suit. You know, I got a badge. I didn't get to shoot nobody or arrest nobody, but it was a cool little scene, man. I had a good time.
Final scene in the movie, the last day. We're about to kill everything, including ourselves.
Everything moving's got to go.
All right, so this is what we're doing tonight. It's the last scene of the night. It's the big finale of the movie, the big shootout. We're making it so it's kind of Reservoir Dogs, Last Man Standing, the Departed kind of vibe. Everybody's kind of gonna run into this whole warehouse. Lazy doesn't know he's about to meet Wish and Crazy and vice versa. No one knows they're about to see each other. They see each other, it's a triangle standoff. And the shit goes down, they all end up killing each other.
Somebody about to die.
Yeah, he kills himself, puts it to the head.
I can't take this shit.
Shit, that shit was real cool. This shit fun in the month. I can't believe how fun it is. I think I'll have to switch occupations real quick. But I'm kind of feeling this, baby. We here till 5 in the morning tonight, so you know. All you motherfuckers that think it's easy.
Man, the fool on the loose with a running hand. I got a show shot, aim for the running man. That'll stop you in the tracks.
Yeah, man, I just got blasted by Big Wish, you dig? Fucked me up pretty bad. I got about 6 or 7 bullet holes.
We're getting down to the final seconds of the movie. I'm already dead. Lazy dead, Wish dead. The movie over.
Just because I'm down don't mean I'm out, player.
Man, I gotta say, Lazy, Crazy, and Wish, just natural superstars. They really brought a lot to this film, and it's not your typical hip-hop movie at all. It's not even a hip-hop movie. It's a real movie where these guys are real actors doing what they do. They're gonna have a long career in movies.
This is the end
of the movie. It's a wrap. Bone Thugs, baby.
See, we all bloody up, man.
Bloody. We got banged out. This stuff is real, real itchy right now, you know what I'm saying? So be looking out for the movie, man. It's coming out.
Yeah.
And buy the album.
Day 13, it's a wrap.
Yeah, yeah. Now Crazy Bone is ripping and sticking these niggas up in the 9 deuce. And all these niggas stepping must get static with my crew. But nigga, bring it on, send the chrome to your dome. Crazy Bone ain't no hoe, I guess mine in the 9 O's. That's how it's done, Brentwood. Rolling, rolling, rolling.
I get mine on the 9-0.
It's your girl Lil Red. I guess mine on the 9-0.
I guess mine's in the 9-0.
Oh, and I definitely get mine on the 9-0 all day. Y'all know what it is.
Mine, on the other hand, gets delivered to the 9-0.
I get mine on
9-0. Hi, I get mine on the
9-0. I get mine on the 9-0.
I get my
mom
on the
9-0. Yo, 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 mine gets brought in to the 9-0.
I guess mine in the 9-0.
I got mine on the 9-0.
I gets mine on the 9-0.
I got mine on the 9-0.
I gets mine on the 9-0.
I got money in 83.
I got mines on the 90.
I get mine on the 90.
But I get mines in the 9-0.
I get silly in the 9-zilly.
Oh yeah, I gets mine on the 9-0. Lead out.
Interscope Records 2007, where the music goes down. I gets mine on the 9-0.